Hey, thank you, Steve, for that last power hour speaker. Welcome, Kathy Perry.
Well, just in case you thought you were getting this Katy Perry, I am so sorry to disappoint. I will not sing, and if you saw me dance, you would want me to leave. No, instead of singing and dancing, I'm going to help you stretch today. We're going to talk about stretching so that you can become more rubber band resilient. Resilient through your disruptive events, your transitions, and your changes, which I know many of you are facing. So my HR career started in Charlotte, North Carolina, a wonderful city. As a trainer in the 1980s, and I know if you trained in the 1980s, you had that suit as well, and the hair was particularly high, but as a trainer, I had the incredibly important job of going out to the branches and working with those employees on the very critical and important task of, wait for it, ATMs. I was the ATM queen, they called me, in branch operations support. Well, I loved being out there and doing the training. So if there was a merger, new software, new machines, new branches, I would call them. Not only did I love being out with those people, I also loved my team. What an amazing team at this financial institution. And my favorite person, and still is to this day, although I've long since left that area, his name was Ron. Ron was the person you wanted to work with. He was humble. He was gregarious. He was fun. You needed something? Ron was there. Well, while I left Charlotte to pursue other things. Ron stayed on. Ron became the head of training and development for this super regional financial institution. He was on his way, working his way up. Soon, about 10 years, less than 10 years after that, he was hired away by the next biggest financial institution in the city to head their training and development. When I talked to Ronnie, he's like, this was a great step in my career. It gave me validation. I knew that I was doing the right thing. But what I really wanted to be working toward being a chief human resource officer. Well, Ron got his break eventually. They came to him at this organization and said, Ron, you are ready. We are moving you up to a division where you will now be over 5,000 employees. You are now one of the highest levels of human resources that we have. Ron was on his way becoming an HR superhero. I bet I have some of you as a group for HR superhero. Well, the thing that Ron told me about this time in his life, however, was he felt stretched. He said, not only were a lot of balls left up in the air when I took this position on, a lot of holes had to be filled. I was feeling really stretched professionally. But my family was growing. I had three young children and a fourth on the way. Everything about my life felt like it was being stretched. Are you being stretched? Right now, you should have a rubber band. Does everyone have a rubber band? If not, ask your neighbors, look around. There is one put on every seat in the room. I would like you to think about your professional life. What disruptions are stretching? Are you having issues with staffing, regulation, or retention an issue? Do you have problems just within your company? I got somebody up here who's ready to shoot, so watch out. On a scale of 0 to 10, how stretched do you feel professionally? Go ahead and hold them up. Show me. Oh, I see a lot of big stretches. Yeah. A lot of you are feeling it. Now, because we don't live in a vacuum, our personal lives come in to what we do every day. We're going to do the same thing. How stretched do you feel personally? Maybe it's your kids. Maybe you're caring for aging parents. Maybe it's finances, a health issue. I think y'all are stretched even more personally. That is not unusual. Well, there's a name for the stretch. You have to go back to ninth grade science class if you remember that name. The type of energy that this stretch holds is potential energy. If you are not stretched, you don't go anywhere. Hold your rubber bands up, do nothing. Don't stretch it at all. Let go. It's a nothing, right? But now the part you've all been waiting for. Sit that rubber band right into your hand. Do not point the rubber band at your coworker, your boss, your friend. On the count of three, we're all going to aim our rubber bands at the ceiling. Straight at the ceiling. I was told we had insurance. One, two, three, release. It's still fun at any age. You are ready to launch. So as you see, your rubber bands went nowhere when they were not stretched. You will go nowhere if you aren't stretched. Well, let's go back to my friend Ron. Ron's in this position for a couple years at this large financial institution. 5,000 people he has under him. And he gets a knock. And they say, Ron, we know that you wanted to stay in this HR executive position, but we have a problem. You know that bank we're going through a merger with? One of the largest bank mergers in the history of the country. Yes, I know which one we're talking about. Our training and development team is not up and ready to the task to bring all those people on board. We need you to leave your HR position, go back to training and development, and head this up. It's going to take 2 to 3 years. You're going to have to build a team of about 1,200, and you're going to be on the road. This was not the stretch that Ron wanted. He felt deceived. He felt like he didn't have what it took to be in the position he was in. He left training and development. He's been there 20 years, and he finally was out. He said, I was about to snap. But it took him a long time to get through that. When you are stretched so far, has anyone done it? I do it all the time. You stretch that rubber band, and it snaps. It hurts. But in order to avoid the snap, you have to reframe the situation. We heard about this briefly this morning, but I want to take you to camp to tell you my version of how to reframe. As a mother of four, I found the beauty of something. Leap away camp. Child number one goes to sleepaway camp. Then child number two goes to sleepaway camp a couple years later. Number three, Graham. He's my most animated. Mom, when do I get to go to sleepaway camp? I'm like, dude, you gotta be eight, okay? Eventually, Graham gets to go to sleepaway camp with his brother. I go and I pick him up. I say, Graham, tell me about sleepaway camp. Mom, it was great. I learned to kayak. I did the zip line. There were so many activities. I go, how was the food? Oh, the food was fine, but what was more fun was the singing that happened in the dining hall. That's great. I go, well, what did you do in the morning after you ate breakfast? Yeah, I knew how the routine worked at camp. I was fishing for one particular answer because I wanted it to happen at home. He's like, I don't know. We did camp, and then we went out. I'm like, no. Before you got to go out, didn't you have to clean the cabin? Because, oh, no, Mom, at camp, we get to clean the cabin. They did that ninja mind trick that we heard about this morning at camp. Well, Ron had to reframe his situation so that he didn't snap. He said, I took those 2 to 3 years, because it ended up being about 2.5 years, I got them on their way to the merger, through the merger, brought all those people on board, and then I said, I've grown. I built a muscle towards this disruption, and I'm ready now to launch. Are you building a muscle towards your disruption? Are you ready? Are you stretched? Are you building it? Let's talk for a minute about building muscle. In order to do that, we got to go to the soccer field. Do I have soccer fans here? Woo! World Cup was this year, so yes, I was in heaven. Well, David Beckham, world-class soccer star, in 2010 went down with one of the worst types of injuries that a soccer player can have, a torn Achilles tendon, down on the field. Well, a torn Achilles tendon takes about 6 months to 12, 6 to 12 months to heal, the difficult surgery, and a lot of rehab. The reason I know this is because in 2016, Kathy Perry went down with a torn Achilles tendon. Not nearly as sexy as David. No, mine was in a dark fire pit, tripping over rocks. But after you go to, you have your surgery, 4 weeks later you go back, and the doctor looks at you, and he writes you a prescription for physical therapy. And you go, and you get something like this. Anyone gone to physical therapy? It's not fun when you're trying to rebuild a muscle. But this is known as a resistance band. And sometimes we have to resist what we don't want to go through. We have to embrace the resistance to build the muscle. I recovered. This is my bad foot. I can stand on it. I built the muscle. What can you be doing to build the muscle towards your disruption? Find someone with more knowledge. You've been hearing that a lot. There are people here who have gone through what you are going through. Find them. Seek them out. Instead of going up to someone and you just got really good tips about how to interact with someone, go up and say, hey, what's been your disruption? How'd you get through it? Next, make a detailed action plan. Sometimes we're so mired in our own self-pity when we're going through a transitional or disruptive event, we forget to plan. Get additional training or education. You're doing that right here. Don't forget to do it all year long. Prioritize your mental health. More than any other sector within the corporate community or organization, you understand the importance of mental health. Pay attention to your own. Don't start getting mired down in the disruption. And finally, personally energize. Take that little self-care. You're not going to get through these big life-changing events if you have no energy. Your disruption can be the beginning of greatness. Ron went on. He got that chief human resource officer position. He still works in human resources. He's still a great person. But he told me if I hadn't built that muscle, I wouldn't be able to do it. I want to give you a few tips and tactics and tools that you can use and take back to build your muscle. You can text the word energy to 66866. This will be in the slides for later. I have a personal resilience toolkit as well as a assessment that you can do with your own team. One last thing. My rubber band ball has 275 rubber bands in it. You just saw the power and potential of about 1,800 rubber bands. But if you bind them together, they bounce back a lot more quickly. Work together. Thank you.